What's up, guys, and welcome to this beautiful and extremely hot summer day. And I've just noticed that today I'm dressed kind of like a Persian arms dealer, but you know, someone has to. So let's talk about the thing that has been bothering me on my RX-8 since day one, and that is the top aluminium part, or my gear shift knob. This part is very easily scratched, and as you can see, it's scratched. I found a fix for this issue on the internet, which was like an aluminium cover that you just glue on top of this aluminium part, and it, you know, restores the shininess of your gear knob. But it happened many times that as I was shifting my gears, I was shifting gears like this, and the aluminium cover just came off my hand. And I tried to reattach that cover several times. I think I did it twice, and it kept getting off, and it was bugging the hell out of me. So I decided to this was enough. I think this car deserves better than the scratched aluminium knob, and so I decided to come up with a more perfect and long-term solution to this problem. So the basic idea behind this is that we go to the hardware store, get some masking tape, get some primer and some chrome paint. So now it's finally time to do some man shopping. So I finally home from the store and away from the dreadful heat that's been plaguing me all day. I have with me the primer and the chrome paint. I'm gonna put on this table all the ingredients we're gonna need, all the products that we're gonna need to paint my shift knob. Okay, this one's full. And I also got the final ingredients for our job, which are this precision cutter and this masking tape. So the idea behind this is that we get our shift knob, we get it clean with our nitro thinner, we mask the central piece of our shift knob where the numbers are with masking tape, and we also mask the leather part here in black. Once this part is done, we spray the silver metal part with primer, we let it dry, and then we give it another two or three coats of this chrome spray. So let me go change my Kazakhstani arms dealer shirt, put on some hobo clothes, and let's finally start this job. And I'm done. I got my favorite shirt on, and now it's time to freaking party. Now we're gonna take a piece of this masking tape and put it on the center of this shift knob, like so, so that we cover the central part where the numbers are. We just press down the tape so that it adheres a little bit better, like so. Now we're gonna take our precision cutter and cut this circle around this part where the numbers are, so that we mask the central piece. So we're gonna take our knife and cut it. Make sure to get a quality knife so that it cuts a clean line. Okay, now that the central piece has been cut, now we can start removing the tape, and only the central piece of this tape should remain on the shift knob. And here we go. Okay. Perfect. Now we can press it down so to make it better adhere. Okay, now that the top of our shift knob is covered, we need to mask the lower leather part. And the way we're gonna do this is that we're gonna take our masking tape. We will position it on the edges where the metal and leather meet. Okay, now that our shift knob is masked to perfection, we can finally put it here and take our nitro thinner, like so. Put it on this paper towel and clean the surface that we're gonna paint. So the metal part over here. We need to make the surface nice and clean so that we will give our primer a better chance of sticking. Okay, I think that this is done. Now that we've cleaned our shift knob, it's finally time to take our primer, shake it up, and start spraying our shift knob. I think my girlfriend will be better at this. Okay, I think that the primer is ready now. Okay, let's test it. Okay, let's start to spray our shift knob. The goal with the primer is to fill all the scratches on the shift knob so that we have a nice smooth surface to later paint the chrome paint. Okay, I think I'm gonna give it two layers of base coat. The first layer just to stick, and the second one to fill all the scratches. So I'm gonna leave this to dry for a bit and then come back and give it a second coat. So now it's time to give it our second coat of primer, which will fill in all the scratches and leave a smooth surface for our chrome. Okay, I think the can is ready. So now let's go and paint the knob. And here we go, the last coat of base coat has been put on the chef knob, and as you can see, the final surface came out pretty uniform. You definitely can't see any scratches on it, and I'm pretty pleased with the final product. So since it's getting darker today, I'll put this chef knob in my garage and let it dry completely until tomorrow, and tomorrow morning we'll start spraying it with our chrome spray. So this is day two of our RX8 chef knob restoration, and as you can see, today is pretty windy outside, so I don't think we'll spray the chef knob on the outside, but we're gonna take it inside the garage and give it that final chrome spray. So let's give our chrome spray one last shake, and now we're ready to paint. Okay, so the first coat of chrome is on, and I'm pretty satisfied with how it attaches to the primer. Okay, so now we're gonna leave this to dry and then give it a second coat. So let's check out the finish, and the paint looks pretty good, pretty uniform. I like it. But I think I want the chef knob to be a little bit more glossy, so I'm gonna head up to the store and buy some clear coat. Okay, and I'm back from the store. I got my clear coat, we're gonna put it aside for a bit, and I'm going to give one last layer of chrome paint on this chef knob to fill all the scratches and to leave a nice and clean uniform surface. Okay, so we're gonna let it dry for a couple of minutes and then come back and hit it with a couple of layers of our clear coat. Okay, we're gonna leave this chef knob here to dry for 24 hours. We're gonna come back tomorrow, take down the masking tape, have a look of the final result, and then install it in my RX8. And the unwrapping day is finally here. So let's go and take our chef knob. Let's have a one last look at it. The color is not the one that I wanted it to be. I thought it would be more mirrorish, you know, that chrome effect, but it came out to be a silver metallic. But enough describing what you can obviously already see. So let's put this down and let's start unwrapping it. Okay, so let's go ahead and start peeling the tape on the sides. So let's go ahead and unmask the top part. And this part came out brilliantly. Okay, so the edges where the leather and the metal meat need to be trimmed down a bit and maybe sanded to blend in the leather so we don't have these masking marks here. And besides that, the central part came out brilliantly. I just have to clear out and clean this internal canal here so that it's more clean. So it might not be perfect, but it's pretty decent. And as a solution, if you manage to get this part right, you have a perfectly fine chef knob. So we've seen that the steel cap solution for the chef knob is a perfect solution that looks great but doesn't really last. But painting your original steel cap seems to be the best solution. All you need to do is to get the edges between the leather and the steel cap right, and then you'll have a practically new chef knob. So if you don't want to miss the buttload of future mods from my Mazda RX8 alongside many tips and tricks, I suggest you hit the subscribe button, and if you like this video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up, and I'll see you guys in my next video.